باب من أفاض على رأسه ثلاثا. The one who أفاض, meaning he poured, على رأسه, on his head, ثلاثا, three times. The one who poured water on his head three times. Why? Why three times? To ensure that the entire head gets wet. The scalp, okay? The entire head gets wet. And why three times and not four? Witr. Allah yuhibbul witr. Allah loves witr. And the other witr would be one, but we know that pouring once is not sufficient. And three times is just enough. This is just like when a person only wipes himself after using the washroom, which we learnt about in Kitab al-Wudu, that there are three ways of cleaning oneself after using the washroom. One is just wiping, the other is just washing, and the other is wiping and washing. So when a person is just wiping, then how many, let's say, rocks or whatever he should use? Odd number, witr, remember? And we know that three is the bare minimum. One is not allowed, because the Prophet ﷺ did not allow the Sahaba to use only one rock or whatever to wipe themselves with. It had to be three times, bare minimum. Beyond that, up to you. But three is the bare minimum. So if you are ever in a situation where you don't have access to water and you're only wiping yourself, then you have to wipe yourself at least how many times? Three times. So similarly, when it comes to washing the head, how many times should the water be poured on the head? A minimum of three times. That is the masnoon way, and that is the better way. حدثنا أبو نعيم قال حدثنا زهير عن أبي إسحاق قال حدثني سليمان بن صرد قال حدثني جبير بن مطعم قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أما أنا, as for myself, فأفيض على رأسي ثلاثا. Then I pour on myself, on my head, three times. Meaning three handfuls of water he would pour on his head. وأشار, and he indicated, بيديه, with his hands, كلتيهما, both of them. Meaning he pointed with both his hands that I pour three handfuls of water, okay, on my head. Now his statement was perhaps an answer to a question that was asked, that how much water should be used. So the Prophet ﷺ gave his own example. He said with his, mentioned his own action, that this is what I do, that I use three handfuls of water to wash my head with. And we learn a very important lesson from this as well. That one is that we just teach people that this is the way, this is the way, this is the way. But when you say this is what I do, then people can kind of relate. People can feel that it is possible. So sometimes if you give a personal example to someone, what's the benefit? That people feel that this is applicable in life. Right? If one person can do it, we can do it too. So the Prophet ﷺ mentioned his own way, that I pour three handfuls on myself. So that means we can also do it. حدثنا محمد بن بشار قال حدثنا غندر قال حدثنا شعبة عن مخول بن راشد عن محمد بن علي عن جابر بن عبد الله قال he said كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يفرغ على رأسه ثلاثا. He said, Jabir ibn Abdullah said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم would pour on his head three times. Now remember that this is masnoon, not wajib. So let's say if a person poured three times, but then he felt that a part of the head is still dry, then what should he do? Fourth time, but make it witr. So fifth time as well. Okay, so this is masnoon. Now, these days when you're standing under a shower head, then what do you do? Huh? How can we follow the sunnah? Because why should we be deprived just because we have shower heads? Yes. You can just put your hands under the running water, take a handful, pour on your head, you know, three times. You can do that. Somebody just mentioned to me that this is what they do. That they take the water in their hands and then they pour. So this is, we can also follow the sunnah today, inshallah. حدثنا أبو نعيم قال حدثنا معمر بن يحيى بن سام حدثني أبو جعفر قال قال لي جابر. So Abu Ja'far, he said that Jabir said to me, قال لي جابر أتاني ابن عمك, the son of your uncle, meaning your cousin, he came to me. So Jabir رضي الله عنه, he said to Abu Ja'far that your cousin came to me. يعرض, and he was hinting at, بالحسن بن محمد بن الحنفية. He was hinting that Hassan bin Muhammad bin Hanafiyyah, he came to me. You understand? No? Okay. حدثني Abu Ja'far. Abu Ja'far is the one who's narrating this. قال, he said, meaning Abu Ja'far said, قال لي جابر. that Jabir said to me. What did he say to me? That Atani ibn Ammik. Atani, he came to me. Who? Ibn, son of Ammik, your paternal uncle. Okay? So the son of your uncle, and who is that? Your cousin. That your cousin came to me, and yu'arridu, he was hinting at bil Hasan bin Muhammad bin Hanafiyyah. So he didn't say that Hasan bin Muhammad came to me. Instead, what did he say? Your cousin came to me. Qala, and he said, كَيْفَ الْغُسْلُ? How is the ghusl min al-janaba, from janaba? Meaning, Hasan bin Muhammad, he asked me, O Abu Ja'far, that how should the ghusl from janaba be taken? كَيْفَ الْغُسْلُ مِنَ الْجَنَابَ? فَقُلْتُ, so I replied to him, and who is saying this? Jabir رضي الله عنه, that I answered him, that كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يأخذ, he would take ثلاثة أكف, three handfuls, ويفيضها على رأسه, and he would pour it on his head. He would take three handfuls of water and pour them on his head. ثم يفيض, then he would pour, meaning pour water, على سائر جسده, upon his entire body. So he would pour three handfuls of water on his head, and then he would pour water on the rest of his body. This was the way that the Prophet ﷺ used to perform ghusl. فَقَالَ لِي الْحَسَنُ, Jabir, he said that Hasan, meaning your cousin, he said to me, إِنِّي رَجُلٌ, indeed I am a man, كَثِيرُ الشَّعْرُ, who has a lot of hair, I have thick hair. So using three handfuls of water is not sufficient for me. فَقُلْتُ, so I said to him, كَانَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَكْثَرَ مِنْكَ شَعْرًا. The Prophet ﷺ was more than you in hair, meaning he had thicker hair. So we see that no matter who asked him about the ghusl of the Prophet ﷺ, about the amount of water, this was his response. He was very firm about this was the amount of water that the Prophet ﷺ used, and this should be sufficient for us as well. And just to tell you who Hasan bin Muhammad bin al-Hanafiyyah is, Muhammad bin al-Hanafiyyah was actually the son of Ali radiallahu anhu. Okay, he was Muhammad bin Ali radiallahu anhu. But he got known as Muhammad bin al-Hanafiyyah. Why? Because al-Hanafiyyah was his mother, you can say. She was from the Sabi, meaning the war captives of the tribe of Banu Hanifa. So Ali radiallahu anhu, he married her. But their son, Muhammad, he got to be known as Muhammad bin Hanafiyyah. Not that a person should be named after their mother, but this is just how he became famous. He was known as Muhammad bin Ali as well, but this is how he was identified as well. So this was Muhammad bin Hanafiyyah, the son of Ali radiallahu anhu. And his son was Hasan. His son was Hasan. So no matter who it was, even from the children of the companions who were related to the Prophet ﷺ, directly or indirectly, okay, through whatever way, still we see that the rest of the companions were so firm that no, this was the way the Prophet ﷺ did ghusl, and it should be enough for you too. So then who are we? Really, who are we? We aren't any special people that we think that no, we have to use more. The masnoon way is that the Prophet ﷺ would first dip his fingers into the water and then wet the scalp. Okay, when you do that, you're creating pathways in a way through your hair. So that when you will pour water, it will automatically reach the scalp. But when those ways are not created, then what will happen? You pour water, but it will fall off from your hair. You can use a bucket of water even, but it won't be sufficient if you don't use the proper technique. Okay, so the technique is what the Sunnah teaches us. And this proves to us that purification is obtained through this much water, meaning three handfuls. The Prophet ﷺ was most knowledgeable of people, the most a'mal, meaning his a'mal was the best. He was most fearful of people. And when he considered using three handfuls to be sufficient, then this much water should be enough for us. And the point over here is that if a person feels that it is not enough, then he should not pay any attention to such thoughts. Why? Because this is the waswasa of shaitan, to make our ghusl difficult and to deprive us from following the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. Really, we are being deprived of the reward. Think about it. How often does a person take a bath? I mean, almost every day, right? And if we, even normal baths, if a person takes in this way, the way that the Prophet ﷺ would take a bath, then imagine how much reward he can be receiving. But we are deprived of this great reward because we feel that we can't do it. So this is something that we should develop a habit of as well. Also remember that using excessive amounts of water, is that good for the skin? Okay, it's not good for the environment. Yes, you're not following the sunnah, but is that good for the skin? It's not even good for the skin. Yes, it dries out the skin. We see that following the sunnah is definitely good. Okay, I'm not saying don't use shampoo, don't use soap. No, use it. But be careful about the use of water. Okay, be more efficient. Then when you will use limited amount of water, then you will know that I can't take a handful of shampoo. I only need as much as is enough for my hair.